Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to discuss about betahistine. What is this drug betahistine? The suffix histine indicates this drug is a synthetic analog of histamine and this drug acts as histamine receptor agonist. So simply betahistine is a histamine analog and this drug is indicated for the treatment of various conditions such as vertigo where there is a reeling sensation, tinnitus, some buzzing noise in the ears, and in the patients with hearing loss, which is associated with vertigo, tinnitus, nausea and vomiting. All these symptoms can be managed by betahistine, which is a histamine agonist. Particularly, these symptoms are associated with any disorder within the inner ear. For instance, Meniere's disease is an inner ear disorder associated with vertigo, tinnitus and hearing loss. In such patients, betahistine can be used. But betahistine not only acts as agonist, it can also act as antagonist on H3 receptors. So today in this video, we are going to discuss how this betahistine acts, what is the mechanism of action, what is its chemical nature, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. So first of all, let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the simple structure of betahistine. So here it is having the pyridine ring system. In the histamine, it is having the imidazole, but here it is having the pyridine ring system. So you can write this suffix as pyridine. And this pyridine is having a ethyl chain. So this is 1 and this is 2. So it is having the 2 ethyl chain. And at the beta position, it is having the methyl amino group. So beta methyl amino group. That is a simple name of betahistine. So betahistine is a histamine derivative with a group at beta position. Now let us see how this drug acts. So within the inner ear, histamine is one of the important neurotransmitter which can be released from the presynaptic neurons and it can act on the postsynaptic neurons as well as target organs. These postsynaptic neurons are expressed with H1 receptors. Similarly, the presynaptic neurons are expressed with H3 receptors which are auto-inhibitory in nature. Now, when the action potential reaches to the presynaptic neurons, calcium can enter and it can produce exocytosis so that histamine can be released and it can act on H1 receptors. In this way, H1 receptors are activated and this impulse is going to be carried up to the blood vessels supplying to the inner ear. So when these H1 receptors are activated, it produces a vasodilatation. In this way, histamine plays a key role in producing the vasodilatory response within the inner ear. But in the Meniere's disease, we can observe increased pressure within the endolymphatic space. So in order to reduce the pressure, these blood vessels should be more dilated. Now, betahistine is one of the histamine analog. It can act on the H1 receptors so that it can further increase the vasodilatation. Now, because of this vasodilatation, the pressure within the endolymphatic space is going to be reduced, which improves the symptoms in the patient such as vertigo, nausea, tinnitus in the patients with Meniere's disease. So this is one of the primary action of betahistine, which acts as H1 receptor agonist, thereby it improves the blood flow to the inner ear. Betahistine can also act on the H3 receptors. Now what are the histamine released through the exocytosis? It can also act on the H3 receptors, which are auto-inhibitory in nature. They can inhibit the release of histamine so that the histaminergic neurotransmission is going to be reduced within the inner ear. Now, betahistine can act as antagonist at these H3 receptors. So, when these receptors are inhibited, it can increase the release of histamine so that histaminergic transmission can be increased. So, betahistine can increase the levels of histamine within the brain as well as within the inner ear, and it can also increase the 5-HT levels. By all of these, the symptoms of Meniere's disease can be reduced. That's why betahistine is used as anti-vertigo agent. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions of betahistine is that this drug can produce few of the gastrointestinal effects which should be closely monitored. This drug can produce some gastrointestinal pain, some bloating, nausea and vomiting, as well as dyspepsia in the patients. So this drug should be carefully given in the patients with any gastric discomfort. And particularly, this drug is contraindicated in the patients with any peptic ulcers because the risk of ulceration is further increased with betahistine. Since betahistine is a histamine analog, it can increase the gastric acid release as well as it can increase the gastric ulceration. So this drug can increase the risk of ulceration in the patients. Similarly, this drug can also affect the lungs and it can produce bronchospasm. So this drug should be carefully given to asthmatic patients. Another important precaution as well as contraindication is in the patients with pheochromocytoma. This is a condition of adrenal tumor. In such patients, betahistine can act on adrenal tumor and it can increase the release of catecholamines, which increase the blood pressure, resulting in hypertension in the patients. So hypertensive crisis can be increased when this betahistine is given in the patients with pheochromocytoma. That's why this drug is contraindicated in these patients. What are the side effects? The important side effects of betahistine mainly include headache, gastrointestinal side effects such as dyspepsia, nausea, abdominal pain, bloating, dyspnea, difficulty in breathing can be observed. Some skin reactions such as itching, skin rashes can be observed, and hypersensitive reactions such as angioedema and urticaria can also be produced by this betahistine. Since betahistine is a histamine analog, it can increase the allergic response, so itching, skin rashes can be observed with this betahistine. How it is given? This drug is available as tablet at 3 strengths, 8 mg, 16 mg as well as 24 mg. The initial dose of this drug is 16 mg given 3 times daily, so the total dose per day is 48 mg. The maintenance dose is variable from 24 to 48 mg given per day, and this dose can be given as divided doses. For instance, 24 mg can be given as 8 mg given 3 times daily, and 48 mg can be given as 16 mg given 3 times, so 16 into 348. Otherwise, it can be given as 24 mg given twice daily. So that's about this drug, betahistine. Betahistine is a histamine analog and it acts as histamine agonist at H1 receptors. It also acts as antagonist at H3 receptors, which is responsible for increased release of histamine as well as other mediators such as 5-HT, which improves the symptoms of Meniere's disease. The primary action is related with the H1 receptor agonism, where it increases the vasodilatation at the blood vessels supplying to the inner ear so that it can reduce the pressure within the endolymphatic space, which reduces the rupture of labyrinth, preventing the loss of hearing as well as other symptoms such as vertigo and tinnitus within the patients. This drug is contraindicated in the pheochromocytoma as well as in the peptic ulcers, and this drug may increase the gastrointestinal side effects such as dyspepsia, bloating, abdominal pain, and it should be carefully given the patients with asthma. This drug is given as 16 mg tablet given 3 times daily, but the dose may be variable from 24 to 48 mg per day given as divided doses. So that's about this drug betahistine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.